Madam, thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to talk on such a sensitive issue. First, I think wholeheartedly this whole house needs to condemn every lynching that happened in this country. It doesn't matter who, which state, what it is. And actually, I was really disappointed with the lead speaker of the ruling party. And I stand here, A, as a mother, as a woman who shares the pain of Saira ji, who lost her 15-year-old son, Junaid. And in his speech, I was really disappointed that a senior member like Hukumdev Narayan ji turned around and said, uska beta mar gaya, lekin aisi cheeze to hoti hai. This is not a random scene. When it happens, he did not show any sensitivity. I'm a woman and as a mother, you may object. I objected to him. I did not disturb him. He said a lot of disturbing things. So let me not challenge you on that. He even talked about China offload and said, hamari taraf se jo karna hai. I challenge him in his speech that if you really have the courage of challenging China, go attack China. We will support you on this. So don't take these things lightly. We were not talking about China. We were talking about lynching. He spoke about China in a speech. Please check the record. If he hasn't spoken about China, I will withdraw my speech. So don't talk about China. Somebody, he talked about China in his speech. So the whole point, ma'am, is lynching is a very sensitive issue. It, what Paswan ji said is absolutely right. We in one voice need to send a message to this country that doesn't matter which caste, creed, city, state or party we come from, we as one parliament condemn it, and that's the message this country is looking for in modern India. So I think that's the resolution we all need to pass together, which we will support the group. And like my own state, madam, I'm so happy Kiran Rijiju is sitting here, who has a very modern view on what people should eat, wear and think, and he leads the home ministry. So I'm looking at him with a lot of hope today with the aspiring India that you talk about. You keep saying this is modern din, achhe din. Then let's put our hand where our mouth is and give us delivery. Even the Shiv Sena unfortunately is not here. We had a lynching issue in Nagpur. My CM, all CMs in this country, better late than never, have condemned it. I must say, be it the Jharkhand CM, be it the Rajasthan CM. But Maharashtra is the only state where the CM, who's so active otherwise, has not said one word against what happened in Nagpur. And there was no proof there was beef. And most vegetarians, sir, you are not from, I never say alert. So let me finish, you have every right to talk about it. The point is that when the Nagpur, if you're a vegetarian, how do you know what that meat looks like? I cook regularly. I can't tell the difference in the two meats. What right did they have to hit that man in Nagpur? Just looking, his wife, all that wife was saying that I want my husband to be alive and I want justice. And what I didn't want to bring the party issue. Both were from BJP and he was the general secretary of the minority of the BJP. What did the chief minister do? Did they say one word? Not one word came out. With the Shiv Sena condemn it, nobody condemned it. This is what happened in my state. I must congratulate the Rajasthan Chief Minister. She had the courage to write an article against mob lynching. I compliment her. Better late than never. But she did it. Jharkhand also, Chief Minister, I compliment. He had the decency to sack the SP there. But he has not done. Maharashtra has not done that. And Maharashtra is a modern state. In our state, we've never had such issues in the last 50 years. So I urge you to take this opportunity and see as why is eating vegan issue. If you can talk about consuming food, if the Goa CM can talk about it, importing it from Karnataka, why can't Maharashtra have the same thing? As a woman, I'm asking you for justice today. And I would urge you to find out why. You talk about Ahimsa. Your government talks about Yoga Day. What is Yoga about? Oh, I'm sorry. Sir, you talk about Yoga Day. We are all happy to do yoga. We are proud of our Indian culture. What does yoga tell you first? Yoga's third portion is asana. First is yam. Yam teaches first about Ahimsa. So why don't we all say that Yoga Day is not about just doing Surya Namaskar, it is about Ahimsa. And that's the message this country needs. So I would urge the Honorable Prime Minister that this is what, and not just to the nation, we are happy to follow something which is interest. He should tell his cadre first, which has unfortunately happened in my state. And I'm so ashamed that my state, which is a modern state, which I'm proud about, has not given us results while other states in this country are. So I urge him to do that. I would just like to say one or two things, madam, only that what happened to Junaid is very unfortunate, and that person who did this to him is out on bail today. Is this the justice system we want to give? I think we condemn it. We all have to find out that if somebody is caught in mouth lynch, in any lynching, doesn't matter who he is, where he is from, he should not get bail. I think we as a house need to send a message to this country that for we should make new regulations that nobody can get bail after killing somebody's 15-year-old child. I can't even think what it is. And what is about food and consume? I mean, mean, Arvind Sawant made such a modern statement. I was very happy to see that. But what about that poor radio jockey of Mumbai, Malishka? All she did was made a simple song against the potholes of Mumbai. And this BJP Shiv Sena government have given her a notice. Is this really the freedom we are looking at? What you eat, what you drink, what you wear, what you say? I mean, she's just a RJ, a radio young jockey, a young woman trying to strive a career. Madam, this is completely injustice. So I urge you, and just want to quote this last one point. I do understand that you are short of time. I would just like to make that, why are people eating this beef? There is a professor, Michael Gordon, who's Irish, who has spent his entire life in Africa. All he's saying that some of this meat in the low-cost incomes need to be consumed because it's a high protein up. So I'd urge the government, if you want a lot of people, nutrition issues, give a solution. Give dal to the entire country. Give all BPL dharaks free dal from tomorrow. I'm sure they'll be happy to change their diet. Why not give that? So if you're not giving them beef to eat, then you give them good dal. There is something we can all debate on. But you can't tell me what to eat. And one time you're saying you want to change this India, make it a just India. You want to get rid of malnutrition. How can you do this with all these kind of issues going on? So I think you really need to the larger picture. And it's no religion tells you to do anything. No religion. I come from an atheist father and a God-loving mother. That doesn't mean my father never told me not to go with my mother, and nor did my mother tell me please come and try. India is very modern, and so is the Hindu religion. Mr. Abdullah is sitting here. His religion never, he 100 times comes to Maharashtra. He's come to temples with all of us. He's gone to Nishikant Dubey's temple in his constituency. He has been. So we all go with this. So how does it matter? Why are we dividing India? And today a lot of people have talked about Lohia ji so much. I just was little amused because so many people talked about Lohia ji. If I remember right, I think Dindal Upadhyay ji in the 1960s lost an election, and Lohia ji did not help him win the election. And Lohia ji had very strong views about Jansang at one time. If I could quote him, ma'am, Pandit Dindal Upadhyay ji's political diary, 30th April 1962. Glancing through press cuttings, I came across a news item in the National Herald, 27th March 1962, reporting a speech of Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia at Allahabad. In this speech, Dr. Lohia stressed, the need of communal harmony is further reported to have said that he would not like to enter into controversy whether the Jansangh was a communal body or not. But he was sure that the Jansangh, by its policies and activities, were widening the gulf between the Hindus and the Muslims. That's not what India is all about. And I think that's the change we need to bring in. You know, 21st century, now you're talking about digital India. This is not a debate, what about digital India? So I actually, with heavy heart, say this. I would just like to end with one quick quote from Rousseau, from The Social Contract, madam. Every man, having been born free and master of himself, no one else may, under any pretext, whatever subject, him without his consent, to assert that the son of a slave is born a slave, is to assert that he is born a man. Thank you very much. Yes.